Bhole Baba, who went missing for 5 days after the stampede that killed 123 people, finally reappears. He speaks to a media network where he says that he's deeply distressed and upset with what he saw. It's unfortunate that that many of his devotees died, and says that the guilty will be punished. Those responsible and behind this will be punished. Unfortunately here, this is the Baba who organized that satsang through his sevadars, but yet there's no FIR against him. He still remains in the shadows, while there are several other arrests of his sevadars who've been carried. The police have carried out several arrests of his sevadars who organized the event by and large, but the real man who actually invited that flock of lakhs of people, he's still on the sidelines. We're going to take you through this report. After going missing for nearly a week, on Saturday at 7:30 p.m., seemingly unfazed, the self-styled godman Suraj Pal, aka Narayan Sakar Hari Bhole Baba, reappeared on television.
हम 2 जुलाई की घटना के बाद बहुत ही व्यथित हैं.
He claimed to be deeply distressed over the tragic stampede that took place at his satsang, claiming 123 lives, and urged his followers to stay strong and have faith in the administration.
सभी शासन एवं प्रशासन पर भरोसा बनाए रखें. हमें विश्वास है जो भी उपद्रवकारी हैं वो बख्शे नहीं जाएंगे.
Remember, this is the same godman who chose to flee and go into hiding as the stampede unfolded, abandoning his followers. India Today has accessed CCTV footage showing him leaving the scene, flanked by his security guards. Interestingly, he isn't even named in the FIR. The UP police claim he'll be questioned if necessary. So far, 6 arrests have been made. The main accused and a close aide of the Baba, Dev Prakash, has surrendered before the police on Friday night, taking all the blame on himself.
मधुकर जो इसमें कार्यक्रम के मुख्य आयोजक थे, इन्होंने ही इन्हीं के नाम से परमिशन ली गई थी, और साथ ही साथ ये कहीं ना कहीं इस कार्यक्रम के लिए उन्होंने फंड भी रेज करा था, तो इनकी दोहरी जिम्मेदारी बनती थी. कहीं ना कहीं बैरिकेडिंग की और वहां पे जितनी सुविधाएं प्रदान करनी थी, पार्किंग के मैनेजमेंट की इनकी जिम्मेदारी थी, पर इन्होंने जो भी सशर्त कंडीशनल जो परमिशन दी गई थी SDM साहब द्वारा, उनका इन्होंने उनको फॉलो नहीं करा था, जिसके बाद इतना बड़ा हादसा हुआ. और जिस समय हादसा हुआ उस समय वहां से फरार हो गए, तो कहीं ना कहीं इनकी जिम्मेदारी बनती थी, इसके बाद इनको गिरफ्तार कर जेल भेजा गया.
The 3-member judicial panel has also started their investigation in the case and has already visited the stampede site.
सर, हमारे लोग बुला रहे हैं, रिपोर्ट कंप्लीट हो जाएगी तो हम भेजेंगे.
सर, कौन कौन से अफसर, सारे लोग बुलाए जाएंगे अफसर जो आप लोगों ने बयान दिए हैं, क्या जांच का दायरा रहेगा?
अभी तो हमको, चूंकि स्टिल वी हैव नॉट इशूड द नोटिफिकेशन, तो साइट पर हम सब जारी करेंगे.
Samajwadi Party Akhilesh Yadav has strongly criticized the UP government, accusing the police of arresting minor suspects to shirk responsibility for the Hathras incident. While the probe is underway to ascertain what led to the tragic stampede in Hathras on July 2nd, Bhole Baba continues to avoid accountability, issuing statements from the shadows. With Santosh Sharma and Himanshu Mishra, Bureau Report, India Today.
We believe that the UP government has decided to give 4 lakhs compensation to the kin of deceased. The question here is, this Bhole Baba, who claims to be a Baba for the poor, has a massive empire worth over 100 crores, owns about 22 ashrams, and not a word of condolence has come from him in terms of compensation, apart from him saying that he is very distressed and upset. He hasn't really promised any kind of compensation or support to his own devotees who've lost their lives and their families. Anila Singh, national spokesperson of the BJP, joins me here. We have Ellen Rao, former DCP of the Delhi Police. Also, Nahid Lari Khan, spokesperson of Samajwadi Party. Thank you very much for joining us. I'd like to take it forward with the former DCP, Ellen Rao. Sir, please give us your take on how should the police be going forward with a case like this. Bhole Baba is the man who's attracted nearly 2.5 lakh people, but it appears that his sevedars have been arrested because permission was taken in one of the sevedars' name. But it's the Baba who's the face of it.
Yes, ma'am, really, good evening to all your viewers. It's a really very sad case, and our sincere condolences to the people, to the families who lost their lives in this case. So far as the investigation is concerned, that I think FIR under appropriate sections has all been registered and investigation is going on. Whosoever is being found involved at the in this case on the basis of so collected evidences, CCTV footage and then permissions and all these things, then the appropriate action is being taken. So many people have been arrested in this case. And
so
this
according to you, Sir Rao,
in whose name,
the cops are not liable to call the Baba for questioning? He's not been summoned?
No. I don't think that the cops will spare him like this. He cannot be spared because he seems to be the main person who caused this incident, because as soon as he told to the crowd that meri charan ras le lo, aur main charan ras dene se meri charan ras se aapka bahut kuch bhala ho jayega, that was the main crux in this case which led to the stampede. And stamp it. That's why I don't think that he can be relieved of his responsibility of this case. He knew that it could happen, because in the case of this culpable not amounting to murder, it is a very important aspect that the person who is knowing that under what circumstances, what he is doing, what action he is taking, that may lead to any death or any injury, to serious injury to any person. That's why he was aware that if I do such thing, and if I do this act of saying that the charanras delo, people may come in a stamp, in a huge crowd, and there may be a stampede. Then it was, and he's not a novice. He's a very renowned Baba right now.
Renowned Baba, absolutely. He's a Baba who's got multiple cases on him. He has past cases on him as well. He seems to be a man who's very well seasoned, understands the emotions of the poor, has managed to tap them, capture them. And really, most of those devotees who were there were fully blinded to be running after that convoy only to try and get his charan dhool. Very tragic and unfortunate. Whatever the reasons that the people had gathered, that number may have been out of despair. They wanted a sign of hope, and they saw Baba to be someone to give them this kind of hope for life. Whatever the reasons are, we're not going to judge on that. But what we're shocked here is the police thinks it's okay not to summon the Baba. It's okay not to file a suo moto FIR against him. It's shocking that they're waiting for someone to file an FIR against the Baba. Only then will they take the case forward. We don't see this kind of process or a delay of such sort on a... And another case, regularly, if a case like this surfaces, you have the police immediately pulling in the man who seems to be the face of the event. That's the procedure. But it appears clearly here that the UP police seemingly have failed. I'm going to bring in BJP spokesperson Anila Singh on this. Anila, would you believe that the UP government at this point could be dragging their feet on this? It's very easy for Yogi Adityanath to carry out bulldozer action as he does, as he's famous for. What's stopping him on Bhole Baba?
My Ram Ram to all. And nothing is making Yogi Adityanath ji drag his feet. He is one person. He has said it in very clear words, whether we talk about the Yogi or the Modi. They don't have anything to lose. They are here to serve people, and they are doing that, and they'll keep on doing that till the public of this country or the state allows them. Secondly, if anyone or someone, they are thinking that Yogi Sarkar is protecting this Baba, and especially if I talk about the opposition leaders, whether Akhilesh ji or whether Rahul ji or anybody else, who thinks that this Baba is in and out, he's the culprit, and FIR should be lodged against him, they might be correct. Why don't you come ahead? You file FIR against him. Ask one of your workers to do that.
Ask one of who to do it?
Why they are dragging their feet behind? You might, allow me, please. Just allow me. Like many, many, many people they are accusing Yogi Sarkar that you have got some interest, political interest, maybe the vote bank interest. That is why you are not taking any action against this Baba. So please come ahead, Akhilesh ji. Please come ahead, Rahul ji. Get any of your worker or yourself. Get up a FIR lodged against him.
Ma'am, there is a process of suo moto cognizance. I hope you're aware of that. I'm not too sure what you're talking about. It's the police's duty to file a suo moto case. This is the norm. In every case, you see the police being steadfast about this. What's stopping them here?
Hold on. Because these political parties or the media is not going to dictate that how the investigation has to be done.
Media has the right to question. I'm sorry. It's not us dictating. We have the right to question. It's about the lives of 123 people. Don't these lives matter? Don't these lives matter at all?
Allow me, Navila. What is this? You have asked me a question.
No, ma'am. You spoke about media dictating. I'm trying to clarify that we're not dictating here. It's my duty to ask.
If media keep on saying, Why this? He is the culprit.
Of course, it's been 6 days, ma'am, and the man hasn't been arrested, let alone an FIR.
According to your dictate, it is not going to function. Investigative committees are formed. Investigation is on. Hunt for this Baba is on.
Hunt for this Baba is on where, madam? He's given a bite to ANI. He's come. He's given a bite to ANI. He's at an ashram. His whereabouts are very well established. We know where he is. I mean, in terms of the media people have arrived at his ashram. We are playing that bite for you. I think you've seen that on our television all through the day today. So it's no surprise on his location. Everyone knows where he is.
This is what I am saying. What media is showing, what media is telling, well and good. You should do your work. You should do your work. And
I think you're more talking about what the media is asking you than what the government ideally should be doing. You should be telling us what is the government doing. Tell us what the government is doing.
Why should we tell? Yeah, once the investigation is completed, you will come to know everything.
No, what has the government done so far? Why didn't you list it out? You're the spokesperson of the party.
Otherwise, like, you go ahead and file an FIR against this person. Nobody is doing that. Why?
I'm sorry, ma'am, but that's not a satisfying answer. Let me quickly cut across to Samajwadi spokesperson, who's also with us. Nahid, please give us a take on the blame game, political blame game. There's been some criticism, even on the SP party members, saying that this Baba could be associated with the Samajwadi party, etc. Tell us more. What do you know of this Bhole Baba? And what do you have to say about the political links with your party?
First of all, Nabila, I could not hear what the BJP spokesperson was saying because her voice is being cut, and also I could not hear your question properly. Anyhow, whatever the question I have understood, let me answer that. See, I really wonder what's the debate all about, and I feel the BJP spokesperson is also not aware that the official statement of the government has already been said regarding the Baba. The senior minister of the BJP government, former governor, Baby Rani Maurya ji, she has clearly stated, it's an official statement of the government, she has clearly stated that Baba is not responsible for the stampede because he was not there when the stampede took place. He had already left from the place. Even the IG, Shalabh Mathur, he has already clearly stated that Baba is not responsible for the stampede. He had already left the place when the stampede took place. So I really wonder what this debate is all about and what is the BJP spokesperson. Either she's not aware of about the government version, or she doesn't read the news because she's not the official spokesperson of the government. She's a party spokesperson. Like, I'm a party spokesperson. Similarly, she's also a party spokesperson. She's not the government spokesperson. See, now what you're talking about, Akhilesh ji, let me also remind you that BJP's senior most leader, Modi ji, he has multiple photographs, and BJP senior leaders have multiple photographs with the world's biggest rapist, Asaram Bapu. It is BJP who released Ram Rahim from jail, a person who has raped so many women. So don't talk about pictures and don't talk about all these things. The most important thing is that this incident took place because of negligence by the government and by the administration. It is total failure of the government and total failure of the administration. Now, why am I saying administration? Because administration is responsible after those people in the administration who gave the permission for 80,000 people They at least gave the permission for 80,000 for a gathering of 80,000. So then the administration becomes responsible, and administration means the government. So it is because of their negligence that such an incident took place. So many people have died, and it is so sad that 99% of women have died.
It's highly unfortunate and tragic. Right. We heard you, and
Let me finish. Just give me a minute, please.
With that kind of magnitude of crowd that was gathering, 80,000 people's permission was given already, which means there had to be that kind of double security arranged. Even a stadium, a massive stadium today where a cricket match happens, 80,000 is a big crowd. But they're well-equipped, well-skilled, with huge security presence. Did we see that kind of arrangement at this Hathras Satsang? That's the big question here. And more importantly, why are we waiting for someone to come forward a final FIR? It's clear that the devotees are probably worried and scared, fear for their future, and are not coming forward to file an FIR because the media spoke to them. And here's what they said. I'm going to cut across to some of the family members who lost their loved ones, what they have to say about the self-styled godman.
आप किसको जिम्मेदार मानते हैं?
हम तो देखो बाबा जी को जिम्मेदार मानते हैं. अगर वो वहाँ नहीं पहुँचता तो इतनी पब्लिक नहीं पहुँचती वहाँ. साकार विश्वरी को, सूरजपाल बाबा को हम जिम्मेदार मानते हैं. अगर वो नहीं पहुँचता वहाँ तो इतनी सारे नहीं मौत नहीं होती. 80,000 चलो मानते हैं, पहुँच भी गया तो 80,000 लोग उसने बुलाए थे, 2.5 लाख लोग पहुँचे हैं वहाँ पर, तो उसको व्यवस्था करवानी चाहिए थी, प्रशासन को बोलना चाहिए था.
जब वहाँ से जब मैं चलाऊँ पंडाल की तरफ तो रोड देखते जा रहा हूँ तो मुझे कहीं नहीं दिखी. जब वहाँ देखा तो वहाँ पर जब माता नरी चप्पल जूता नरी और भर भर के वहाँ पे एक साइड में करी जा रही है. यहाँ मैंने यहाँ का आया हुआ तो वहाँ के कुछ लोग बोल रहे यहाँ बहुत लाश है. बाकी बाद में फिर मैंने हमारी गांव की एक भाभी बैठी वहाँ, मैंने भाभी तुमने हमारी मंजू को मेरे पीके को देखो, तो बोली छोटे मैंने ना देखो. तो बनते ही मैंने फिर पांडाल के सांड के पास की मैंने सीधे लगा ली. सांड के पास भी जब मैं पहुंचा तो मेरा बेटा सांड वारन के पास में बिल्कुल कुछ नहीं था, बिल्कुल पड़ा था मेरा बेटा. तो मैंने कि भैया जी, तो मेरा बेटा बोले भैया इसको हम ले गए, मेरे नहीं बचा पाए. मैंने भैया की मम्मी कहाँ है, तो भैया पता नहीं, देख लो. मैंने कि अगर होती तो मैंने मेरे बेटा के पास होती. मैंने कि अगर होती मेरे बेटा के पास बैठी रो रही होती, मेरी बहू ना रही थी, कैसे नहीं आ रहे.
अभी आप लोग क्या चाह रहे हैं? राहुल गांधी से भी बात हुई, क्या गिरफ्तारी हो नारायण साकार हरी की, या इसमें आप मानते हैं कि जो प्रशासन है उसकी गलती है?
भैया गुनहगार को सजा मिले, सत्संग तो बहुत करे, मगर ऐसे धक्का मुक्की हमने कहीं ना देखे. जहाँ पता ना कौन की काब हो, कैसे काब हो, मैं कुछ नहीं कह सकता हूँ. चाहे गिरफ्तारी कर लो, चाहे फांसी कर लो, मेरे बीवी बच्चा तो लौट के आने वाले हैं ना.
बाबा चमत्कारी है कि नहीं है?
बाबा जब एक सौ 21 मरे, इनका जीवित कर दे तो हम मनवे की आई भगवान आई, और नहीं वो अंधविश्वास में आए जिंदा करे पहले.
All right, so that's the grieving families who are outrightly blaming the Baba. And the very pertinent question, if this man has the kind of magic he holds, then why can't he revive the people who died? Of course, they're speaking out of emotion. But legally speaking here, this man, Bhole Baba, was the face of the satsang. He's invited through his sevadars, lakhs of people, without proper arrangements in place and facilities to accommodate that crowd. And yet he doesn't face an FIR, and there's no summons as well by the UP police. We know that many other people have been arrested. One close aide of the Baba today has come and surrendered before the police, saying, I take all responsibility for the failure in arrangement. And I hope, I really hope that the police don't stop there. They go on to summon the Baba, and he should be, FIR should be filed against him. Because this is not a third-party event where he was attending. It was his satsang. He was not a guest at this event here. It was his event altogether. So I'm not too sure what the police here is failing to see. If I could bring in our former cop as well. Sir Rao, please tell us more on what the law really says. He's a face of this satsang. He's not attending a third-party event. He's not a guest at another event. It's his event altogether. So when you hear the devotees clearly speaking, saying the Baba is responsible for lack of facilities there for that large crowd, I'm surprised, astonished that the police does not think it's important to summon him even for questioning.
Ma'am, first of all, I want to clarify on the FIR part, because initial FIR has already been registered under section 105, that is culpable homicide not amounting to murder of section of BNS, Bhartiya Nyaya Sangita. and it is not important that whether any person is yet to be arrested, he should be initially found, his name should be found in that FIR. Names can be added in that similar FIR. No fresh FIR is required to be registered, number one. In this FIR only, the person can be arrested. Even the Baba, if there is sufficient evidence, he definitely will be arrested in this case. Nobody is going to spare him. Number two, whatever was the SOP. SOP means whatever the SOP of standard operating procedure of the function to be held at like this. Because the permission was granted for 80,000 people, and why it was gathered more than 2.5 lakhs.
Yeah.
This was the main point which was to be seen by the administration, police department at their presence, that if so many people are there, why they are violating the condition of the permission. Permission was granted to the organizers, and the main person under whose signature the permission was applied for, he has been, I think, arrested. And that's why, because he violated, and he and other sevadars,
yeah,
other organizers have been arrested in this case. And I think that Baba will also be issued notice or summons in this case.
So we're really waiting for that, because it's unbearable to see the families of those deceased. They're inconsolable. And it's shocking that this Baba, who otherwise has this kind of wealth, he boasts of nearly 100 crores as his assets. He has 22 ashrams, quite a rich man for a poor man's Baba, has not even announced any compensation of that sort for the devotees' families who died. And he also, more importantly, has a dubious past himself. He's had many cases in the past, and he's let off quite easy. There was an FIR filed against him in Agra after he failed to revive a dead girl. So magic treatment, all sorts of things that he's done even in the past, and he's gotten away with it. This is the kind of clout this Baba holds quite clearly. But I want to get your attention here, our viewers, on the wealth this Baba has. He's, of course, at this point, 6 days on and still free, not even called for questioning. But here's a quick look. The man who's not even turned around to look at the devotees and promised any kind of compensation for them owns an empire worth 100 crores. He describes himself as a deity of the poor man, but has 22 swanky ashrams, walks with a convoy, lives really like a king. You have a look.
This is not so Bhole Baba's empire of faith in Mainpuri. Surajpal, aka Narayan Sakar Hari, aka Bhole Baba, the man behind the large religious gatherings at Hathras that ended in a deeply stampede, owns assets worth over 100 crore rupees that include 22 swanky ashrams across Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan, equipped with AC rooms and plush interiors. He travels in a convoy of 15 to 30 vehicles led by 16 commandos in black fatigues. This ashram is Bichwa, Mainpuri, built on 21 bighas of land on the Aligarh GT road, is said to be worth crores. The ashram has a luxurious mansion for the Baba and a garage to keep all his luxury cars. With this expansive estate, 6 rooms are exclusively reserved for him and his wife. Apart from Mainpuri, Surajpal or Bhole Baba also has ashrams in Kashganj, Agra, Kanpur, Shahjahanpur and Gwalior as well. India Today visited the Baba's ashram in Kanpur.
Right behind me is the Singhasan of the Baba and the Devi Ma, which you can clearly see how beautifully it has been decorated, just like it's a Singhasan, the throne of any Rajput ruler or a Mughal ruler. And you can clearly see the Baba sitting there alongside is his wife, which they call the Devi Ma. Not just that Singhasan, that throne, but also you can clearly see that some signals quite here, and these jhulas are also placed here. So these are the things which in a way makes it a different ashram.
Dressed in white suits and shoes and colorful ties, Bhole Baba teaches humanism while flaunting expensive watches and flashy sunglasses. Sevadars call him God. Believers say that he is an avatar of Paramatma.
Rangoli se mitti uthani hoti
aate hain jahan se nikalte utha koi masti isme lagata hai koi ghar le jata hai system ye hai charan rajo kisi ke unke nadi koi ja hi nahi pata hai
avatar mante hain baba ko
hum to param satta mante hain
sadish mante hain
साजिश में ही लोग बता रहे हैं।
कितने साल पहले बनाए?
ये 2-3 साल हो गए।
आप लोग हर रोज सेवा देते हैं?
यहाँ साफ सफाई होती है।
क्या होता है
यहाँ? मंगल मंगल दर्शन करके चले जाते हैं, बस साफ सफाई होती है।
गाना भजन भी होता है?
नहीं कुछ नहीं होता,
स्पीकर रखे बड़े बड़े पीछे,
वो ऐसा रख दिए गए हैं लेके आगे व्यवस्था के लिए।
द मैन हु डिस्क्राइब्स हिमसेल्फ एज द डेटी ऑफ द पुअर एंड मार्जिनलाइज्ड लिव्स लाइफ किंग साइज। ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे।
All right, this Baba certainly here faces criminal liability. If we have our a quick word from Anila, a BJP spokesperson. Anila, a word from the government. If you could give us your take on finally what the government is mulling over to pin this Baba down, because the wait is excruciating for the family members. 6 days on, he faces no action.
Anila, I'll make two quick comments here. Number one. As I told you, have some faith in the government, have some faith in the system, whether we talk about the police administration or the judicial thing. And very soon you will come to know that even this Baba will be questioned and he will be facing the right action against him. Nobody is going to spare him. And secondly, I just want to make one quick comment also here. A spokesperson, Samajwadi Party, she said, perhaps I do not have proper knowledge and Baby Rani Maurya said this. Of course, Baby Rani Maurya made a statement, but is she amongst the three ministers who had come to see the whole matter? She didn't.
She's still part of the government. I'm sorry, she's a minister. Her words will be held accountable. But no time for debate. I'm sorry, we've heard you, Anila. We're hoping that what you say is true. We are going to keep patience and see if at all the UP government really steps up, pulls this man out. It's also the responsibility of the police, the court and the government to take this up suo moto and ensure this man faces legal proceedings. Thanks very much, our panelists, for joining us.